Hello friends, in this video we will learn about the unitary features of the Constitution of India. Previously we learned the federal features of the Constitution of India. Before going into the unitary features, please do subscribe to Pathshala and also click the bell icon so that you will be notified every time a new video is posted. Let's see the unitary features of the Constitution. The unitary features of the Constitution include strong center, states not indestructible, single constitution, the flexibility of the constitution, no equality of state representation, emergency provisions, single citizenship, integrated judiciary, all India services, integrated audit missionary, parliament authorities over state list, appointment of governor, integrated election missionary, veto over state bills. Now let's see in detail about each of the unitary features of the constitution. First one is the strong center. The division of powers made by the constitution between the center and the states is mostly in favor of the center. And when we see it from the federal angle, it is highly unfair. The union list contains more subjects than the state list, and the more important subjects have been included in the union list. The center has the power to cancel the decision of the states on the subjects present in the concurrent list. In the matters of the residuary subject, the center will take charge. By all these, we can clearly see that the center is given more power than the states in our country. In the United States, the residuary powers are given to the states. Next one is states not indestructible. The states in India have no right to territorial integrity. Territorial integrity means the nation or the state should not attempt to promote movements that are related to the separation from the country or to promote border changes in the other nation states. The parliament alone can change the area, boundaries or names of any states. For doing so, the parliament requires only a simple majority and not a special majority. Because of this reason, the Indian Federation is known as Indestructible Union of Destructible States. The American Federation is described as an Indestructible Union of Indestructible States. Single Constitution. Usually in a federal form of government, the states have the right to frame their own constitution, which is separate from that of the center. But in India, states don't have such power to frame their own constitution. The Constitution of India represents not only the constitution of the center but also the constitution of the states. So both the center and the states must operate within this single framework. The flexibility of the constitution. In the federal features of the Indian constitution, we learnt about the rigid constitution where the process of amendment is not so simple. But our constitution is also not so rigid when compared to those of the other federations. The greater part of the constitution can be amended by the unilateral action of the parliament, whether by simple majority or by special majority. But the power to initiate an amendment to the constitution lies only with the center in India. As in the United States, the states can also propose an amendment to the constitution. Next one is no equality of state representation. In India, the states are given representation in the Rajya Sabha on the basis of the population. That is the reason the membership varies from 1 to 31 for different states in the Rajya Sabha. Whereas the United States follows the principle of equal representation of the states in the upper house. That is the reason why the American Senate has 100 members, 2 from each state. They believe that this principle can safeguard the smaller states. Next feature is the emergency provisions. The constitution mentions 3 types of emergencies. They are national, state and financial emergencies. During any emergencies, all the power goes to the central government and the states go to the control of the central government. During an emergency, our country is converted into a unitary form of government from the federal government without any formal amendment of the constitution. This kind of transforming from the federal structure to the unitary structure is not found in any other federation. Single citizenship. Though India follows dual polity of central and state government, the Constitution of India adopted the single citizenship system. Canada also follows a single citizenship system. A citizen of India, irrespective of state in which he or she is born or reside, will enjoy the same rights all over the country. There is only Indian citizenship and no separate state citizenship. Whereas some other federal governments like United States, Switzerland and Australia follows dual citizenship, which means that the citizens of those nations will have both national citizenship and state citizenship. Integrated judiciary. The Constitution of India follows an integrated judicial system. In this integrated judicial system, we have the Supreme Court at the top level and the state high courts work below it. This single system of courts makes sure that both the central laws as well as the state laws are obeyed. In the United States, there is a double system of courts. Federal laws are implemented by federal judiciary and the state laws are implemented by the state judiciary. Next feature is the All India Services. In the United States, the federal government and the state governments have separate public service commission. In India also, we have separate public service commissions for the center and the states. But in addition, in India, there are some services which are under the civil services like the IAS, IPS and IFS. These services are common to both the center and the states. The members of the services are recruited and trained by the center. The central government passes ultimate control over these services. With the common services for both the center and state, India violates the principle of federalism under the Constitution in the category of All India Services. Integrated audit machinery. The Comptroller and Auditor General of India audits the accounts of both the central government and the state governments, but the appointment and the removal of the Comptroller and Auditor General of India is done by the President without consulting the states. For this reason, the Office of the Comptroller and Auditor General of India restricts the financial sovereignty of the states. Next one is the Parliament authority over state list. In our government, the states are given limited powers. Even in those limited powers, the states do not have exclusive control. If Rajya Sabha passes a resolution to make a change in regard to the national interest, then the Parliament is given powers to make laws on any subject of the state list. This means that the law-making ability of the Parliament can be extended without amending the Constitution. Here we have to remember that this can be done, that is the Parliament getting the powers to make laws in regard to the state list when Rajya Sabha passes the resolution, there should be no need of any emergency situation going on in the state or the country. Next one is the appointment of the Governor. The Governor is the head of the state and he is appointed by the President. The Governor holds the office as and when President wishes. He also acts as an agent of the center to the states. The center exercises control over the states through the Governor. The American Constitution is in opposition to our Constitution in the matter of appointing Governor. In America, the states will get an elected head. In this aspect, India adopted the Canadian system. Integrated election machinery. In India, we follow integrated election machinery. This means the election commission conducts elections to both the central and the state legislature. This election commission is constituted by the president and the states have nothing to talk about this. The states have nothing to say even in the matters of the removal of the members of the election commission. Whereas in the United States, there are separate types of machinery for conducting the elections at the federal level and the state level. Next one is the veto over state bills. In certain type of bills, when they are passed by the state legislature, the government has the power to reserve them for the consideration of the president. The president can hold back his approval to such bills not only the first time, but also the second time. This shows that the president enjoys absolute veto over state bills. But he cannot enjoy suspensive veto. We will learn about these vetoes in the coming videos, but in the United States and in Australia, the states are independent within their field and there are no laws for any such reservation. These are all the unitary features of the Indian Constitution. If you enjoyed this video, do like, share, subscribe and comment on this video, your opinions and suggestions. Thank you. Have a great time.